start this end of the strip, Punta Prima Strip, which is bang opposite the KFC there, that's not long been open, a few months now, and a great little restaurant over there, beautiful, picturesque. We're going to show you that. They do sushi and good menus of the day, the Nesta. But we're going to start off Chicomi, which is an Italian restaurant, and I've heard lots of good reports about this place. We're going to go and check out the menu. So yeah, not too expensive actually. I mean, you can get a pizza here for around €14 for a pizza. And if you're into a pasta dish, you're looking at the same price, around €14 for a pasta dish. And they say it's very popular, this one. I've heard so many good reports. We'll have a quick look inside if we can.
It's a big restaurant. We'd be open later on and it'd be absolutely banged out because it's got such a good reputation.
Got all this seating area, absolutely lovely evening time, and you've got a nice little bar. If you're looking for a nice restaurant, like, it's only round the corner, Torrevieja, and very easy to get to, lots of parking, and there's a lot of different restaurants here. Good choice of restaurants to choose from. And bang next door to Chicoma, we've got a tapas and pasta bar, just here, La Gabelis bar. And they do all sorts in there. You can get a tapas from around €3 or €4, and even do cocktails, €6.50. But you can get a pasta in here if you're into pastas, a spaghetti bolognese. They're like €8, €9, lasagnas. So do a mixture of all sorts in here, salads, sandwiches. Door, we've got a nice Venus restaurant takeaway, another pizza place. They do a good old mixture of pizzas and pastas and all sorts here. They're not as expensive as the one on the end, but it's a takeaway as well, so it's a little bit cheaper, around about €9.50 for a pizza. Do a good mixture, your salads, crab, and even a bit of fish in here. €16 for a bit of salmon and a fillet fish, roque, bit of sauce on it. And also they do a menu of the day here. Three plates with a drink for €11.95. Right next door you got the White Star, that's been closed for a while. This is an empty unit. But yeah, White Star's been closed for a long time. You've got another little spicy store here. If you're after spices, as well as doing all the beach stuff and buckets and spades and postcards and everything like that, you can go in there and you can get your spices. So if you're into Indian cooking, after some spices, that's just in this shop just here. Further along we've got some more bars, and these bars are a little bit busy because they're right in the sun now and it's getting on at 3 in the afternoon, so they're starting to come out for their lunch. So right along here you've got another bar, like I say, Enigma coffee and drink bar. And they've got quite a few in there. We're going to check what sort of prices they're charging. We've got an happy hour in here as well. That might be why they're all here this time of day. It's a gin and tonic for €5. Sex on the beach, there we go. A good list of cocktails here for €5. Nice and pretty inside as well. And if you're into food, they do a good tapas restaurant. They do a good tapas here as well. They do a free course menu of the day here. Greek salad, Russian, seafood, peppers, stuffed with cod. The mains course, you can have a tenderloin, fillet beef, mushrooms, grilled egg, spaghetti bolognese, and it comes with a drink or a dessert. How about that, eh? Cheap as chips, €10.90. Now that's not bad, now the prices are going up. Other than that, if you didn't want to order that, you can order yourself some tapas. So yeah, a need one. Not bad, eh? Further along, we've got some more bars.
We've got a sports bar just there, I've just noticed. Magani. If you're into bet, sports betting, you can go in there, put your football on. Sports bar, and we've got a big area out here, you can watch it on telly. And also, right up here on the far end, you've got a nice posh little bar here. I'm not sure what the name is, but we'll soon find out. They're advertising cocktails here as well. But no prices. Lots of games down the side, as you can see. Nice, pretty little bar. All I can see is Estrella Levante, if anyone knows the real name of it. But yeah, got quite a few people in there as well. And if you missed the looky looky man, you can see him down here. He's taking a well earned rest. And next door to that bar with no name, apart from Estrella Venti, which is the name of another drink, but we've got this Italian here, and it's a gelatiera Italian. And got a few people in here. They also do a menu of the day, so you get a lot of menus of the day just along here. And it's a nice place to sit in the sun as well. €10.90 comes with a dessert or a coffee. Fish and chips, €9.10. Or menu two, which is a grilled bit of chicken breast, Mediterranean, and that's the €10.90 one. So you've got two menus of the day there, the €9.10, a bit of fish and chips, or you can go for the number two, Mediterranean chicken. You've got the bank here, and right next to the bank, you've got Piccolini, which is part of a chain. They do good menus of the day, not bad here. I've been at the Piccadilly chain, and you do get quite people come to these menus of the day. You know why? It's cheap as chips, €9.90. Next door to that one, we got a posh one here. It's called TSM. I think that's how you say it. And we've got right next door to that, we've got Gandhi's Indian restaurant. Personally, I've been to this, I wouldn't recommend it. It's probably one of the worst I've been to, and it's not cheap. But if you're in the area, you want to give it a go, we've got Gandhi's just there. And they do a lunchtime menu of the day between 1 and 3. So it's definitely a 2-hour time scale here. But €12.95. It comes with pot of doms, onion bhaji, chicken Alicante, rice naan. It's not even a big menu of the day selection. Further on, right up here, we've got another bar. And this bar always seems to be busy. It must have a lot of regulars. A good mixture of nationalities here as well. That's right next to the Santander. The old Eclipse. Which is right next door to Marco Polo. Marco Polo's got two bars now. They've got this one, which has been here the longest, and they've got one just across the road, which is really posh and nice. We're gonna have a look at that when we go across. But this one's been here a while. This is original Marco Polo. And right next door, we've got the estate agents, which is quite big, got all the boards outside. You wanna check out the houses in the area. All the flags are out. And on the corner, you've got this other one, which Yoko, which is very popular for the locals because it is cheap as chips as well. They call it a 5-course menu, but really it's 3 courses. They're not big courses, but they label it as 5-course, which comes with a soup or a chicken sweet corn. You can have a second course. You've got another list you pick from, the chicken roll or spring roll. Then you've got your curry, and then you get your rice and noodles or chips, and then you get your drink or, and a dessert.
And the dessert's like tiny ice cream, really small, but it's cheap as chips. It's 12 euros for a menu of the day, which they call five course, which really is only three. But yeah, it does get busy. And they've got all this sea area outside, and in the evening it does get super packed. They have all the, all this will be full. So that's Yoga, Punta Prima. Now we're going to chow you across. We're going to show you this other big restaurant I was pointing out earlier on, which is very popular. And then we're going to work our way around to the strip that's only been there a few years, and it's got new bars opening up all the time. And we're going to... So that's Punta Prima strip. On the left hand side, who's going up towards the Zenia, Cabaroy. We're going to cross over. We're going to show that lovely little beautiful, absolute beautiful restaurant just over there. They do a menu that they sushi.
So we crossed the road from where we was, just over the strip, and we're over now by the new KFC, which is just there. You got a couple of new burger stalls open just here and a chicken stall. But we're going to check out Dinistia restaurant. Menu of the days from 12 to 4, 12.95, and it's absolutely picturesque, this place. We're going to go inside, have a look, and we'll quickly have a look what the sushi bar is serving up today.
Yeah. So, 12.95, absolute bargain. Going to show you inside this place, absolutely picturesque. Absolutely massive in this place, and it, you can see it's chock-a-block, and it's 3 o'clock in the afternoon. So many seating areas. They've even got a big function room as well here. But yeah, absolutely beautiful.
So there you go, that was Dinistia. Very busy. You can see it was getting fuller by the moment I was here, and it's just an hour to go before the menu of the day finishes. On the Punta Prima roundabout on the other side of the strip, and we're going to check out these amazing restaurants just along here, as well as the Asian kitchen, which is very picturesque. I'm going to show you one of the best Indians I've ever eaten in Spain. So we're going to show you along here and show you what prices the menus of the day are. First of all, we're going to start off with the Asian kitchen. Very, very busy. Always seems to be busy, this place. So it's done up very, very posh. The reason why this place is so popular, they do an $11.95 menu of the day with a drink from Monday to Friday, 1 to 4 o'clock. To get down here and come to this picturesque restaurant, Asian kitchen. I tell you what, we're going to take a look inside. Right next door to the Asian kitchen, you've got an Italian saloon, quite busy in there. Absolutely nice picture there. next door to that, it's not a bar or a restaurant, it's a beauty saloon, and it's called Kira. And in here they do all stuff for men and women, anti-aging cream, the lot, full manicures, waxing, you name it, they do it in here. There we go, posh beauty saloon. Next door to that, we have Carne a la Piedra. I think that's how you pronounce it anyway. So if you did want to come to La Piedra, absolutely beautiful speciality they do. They cook everything in an oven, and it's cooked in a special way that comes with salad. It's their only way of doing things, but they do a menu of the day for 12 euros. And with a menu of the day, you can get nachos, chicken, the main portion, we even have salmon. You can have a chicken with spinach, barbecue, ribs, and it comes with a dessert or coffee. 12 euros, cheap as chips. And also, absolutely, look, I've just caught some coming out just now. Even into hamburgers as well. Yeah, pretty little restaurant. And that was a nice barman. He's given me all the information I need. Thank you. Gracias. Next door is a very popular place called the Bridge House, and they do big portions, and the service can be a bit slow, but when it comes, it's definitely worth waiting for. The food's good food. We're going to have a quick look inside. This place can get very, very busy. We're going to check out the prices, but I do know they do a good starter here for around 995 euros, and it's for two people, and it's quite filling. It's a meal on its own, so if you just want a few drinks and a starter, it comes with chicken, onion rings, a good mixture. But yeah, it's not too expensive. I mean, you can get fish and chips here for 13 euros, you can get a good quality grilled tomahawk steak here for two people for 39 euros. Jack Daniel burgers to die for. We've had a Jack Dan burger with chips, absolutely beautiful. I mean, that's 17 euros. Comes with chips and everything, proper meal, but it's nice. Right next door to the Bridge House. It doesn't do many of the day, the Bridge House, is because the food's pretty cheap, and like I say, it's good value for money. But we've got next door, it's called itself International Delicious, because they do the Mexican, the Indian and Italian, and they also do a menu of the day here, which is $12.95, which is a fish of the day. You can have a Greek salad for starters, or vegetables, soup, ice cream or coffee. Yeah, $12.95, menu of the day in Delicious. We've got Marco, which is Marco Polo, which is the same as the one across the road. This is the one open a new branch up over here, and it does get very busy in here, and a very picturesque inside. It's the cocktail bar inside, and also they do food, and they do have a lot of entertainment on here as well. They do get singers in the evening. You get an English breakfast in here for 8 euros, which is 2 eggs, 2 bacon, hash browns, mushrooms, the full works with a drink for 8 euros. Continental breakfast, omelette, scrambling, eggs, pizzas, yeah, everything in here. All your basic little stuff here, barbecue ribs.
This place is absolutely buzzing. I'll take you inside, show you inside. So picturesque, like many of the other bars along here.
we've got the Halloween out already. And next door to Marco Polo, you've got this Indian, which I highly recommend. Like I say, very good. They do a menu of the day here. And I'm going to check out what the price is, because as it's all sneaking up every time, been here quite a few times, and it is a proper banging curry. And I've tried many out here, and I need yet to find one better than this place. I found one of the owners or the workers here, and he's going to tell me what the menu of the day is. And as I said, it is banging, so you need to get down there. I know it's between 1 and 4. So we've got the man here. He's going to tell us what you get for the menu of the day.
Yes, in the menu you can choose from the starters. We have 4 starters in this one: the vegetable pakora, vegetable samosa, chicken samosa, aloo tikki, and all are the mouth-watering dishes.
Oh, I know, it's good.
In the starters, and in the main course you can have chicken curry, prawn curry, lamb curry, chicken tikka masala, or if you want vegetarian, you have a mixed veg for you. And you can choose like mild, medium, hot, it depends on you. We can make it according to that, with rice or naan bread.
And
the finish of the meal, you can have ice cream or coffee.
And
you finish that one.
And that price for that?
And it's just €12.95.
€12.95 with a drink. That is what I call bargain, cheap as chips. And if he ain't made you hungry, he's made me hungry.
Thank you.
Yeah, so that's from the man himself. Couldn't explain it better. So you've got an idea what you get for the menu of the day, but it's between 1 and 4 if you want that. Other than that, if you come after that, you just have to pick off the menu, which is not too sad. You still get taste what you want. That was a superb Indian, and right on the end, which is right next door to Ranvia, classic takeaway restaurant. There you can see right on the end, which is next door to the designer furniture shop, Valentin Sanchez, upmarket furniture, big showroom here, right on the corner. So if you're in a bit of upmarket furniture, I want to have a look before you go and have one of these meals along this strip. We're going to cross the road now. We're going to take you over the other side. And like I say, we've got one of these popular places which they recommend is the best fish and chips in the area. Also, it's supposed to be great for breakfast as well. And they do have entertainment. Okay, so we crossed over from that strip just there where we was just now, right over there. We went past all them restaurants just there. And right on the end, we was at the big showroom. So now we've crossed over, we've got the McDonald's here right in the far corner. We can start off at a McDonald's, and also I can show you this amazing restaurant, proper Spanish restaurant with flamenco dance. And you do have to book this place because it is absolutely picturesque and always booked. So if you're into a bit of flamenco dancing and have a nice Spanish meal, I'm going to take you there right now before I show you these bars and restaurants. And also we're going to take you at the top, show you this fish and chip place. So yeah, just by the McDonald's just there, which is across the road from the first lot of bars we showed you and the other ones. And you've got Hotel Torrevieja now. And the bus stop, of course. And this is where the bus stops. And also, if you're picking up coaches from anywhere, this is the main coach stop as well, where they pick and drop you up. But yeah, by the McDonald's, we've got this amazing restaurant, Patio Andalusia. And it is absolutely amazing. So picturesque. I might be able to get a little sneak inside for you. It comes alive at night. That's when the main dancers and everyone comes for their meal. Do stress, if you come for a meal at night, you do have to book. They do a menu of the day, yeah. Menu of the day, you don't need to book, but nighttime you do. So if you come for a menu of the day, which is a Monday menu of the day to Friday, you get a couple of plates of food, it says there, with a coffee, $12.90. And you've got a Cuban rice, Cubana rice, mixed salad, this is your starter and your soup, And if you want the main courses, a chicken schnitzel, rabbit and garlic, macaroni, fried sardines. And then you finish up with a dessert or a coffee. If you're in a dessert, ice cream, honeymoon milkshake.
Yeah, not a great menu of the day, to be truthful. But if you're coming for an evening meal, you get everything. Yeah, your steaks, your fish, your haddocks, your rabbit. You get the full lot here. Yeah? I'll take you inside and have a look around. And this is the kitchen where it all goes on. This is where the barbecue, the food, and all the steaks and the fish is just in here. You see this a lot at night. And believe me, you won't be able to move in here come 8 o'clock tonight. They'll have the flamingos dancing away on stage. You do get, I think, two or three lots of groups of entertainment come in here and do their little bit. They go around the tables, get you a sample to drink. Absolutely great night. So that was Patio Andalus. If you did want to see more of it, on my channel I have done a video the night we went now, and you can see what it's like at night time, but you do have to book. So I've done it to tell you about the McDonald's. You know all about McDonald's, same everywhere you go around the world. But next door you've got the Jysk, big furniture shop here. All your outside furniture, inside pillowcases, Christmas bits, candles, usual stuff. And they're branching out there. They've got a big one open in Casada, and just down the road here, Los Altos Dream Meals 2, you got a new one out on the corner. So the Jysk, yeah, getting big. And right next door at the Jysk, you've got the post office, and you can get your stamps and post all your stuff back to the UK or wherever you want to go. If you're after any special birthday cards, the post office. Yeah, very friendly in here. And you get all your postcards in here as well. Had a little bit of a refurb since the last time I come in here. They've changed it around a little bit.
Hello.
Yeah, so the shop's halved since the last time we come, but they've actually still do the post stuff in here, and your cars is posting all the stuff back to the UK. And next door, I've been told, is gonna end up a tobacconist just there. So if you need a tobacco, that'll be opening very soon. And this card place, which has changed its name, I think, as well, I've opened a new branch upstairs, which we're going to be visiting after we've just gone along here, past the Droney Chemist, and right to the end, we've got where you put your lucky numbers on, your Euro Millions, right at the end here, which is sandwiched in the corner by Millar's, which is a very popular electrical store for your ovens and your air conditionings and cooker stuffs. Yeah, Millar's, well known. So yeah, we've got the Droney here. And just to the left, we've got the pharmacy. Pick up your prescriptions in the pharmacy there. Used to be able to get antibiotics over the counter. I'm not sure if you still can. And right in the corner there, looks like they're on a bit of a siesta, because we're banging siesta time. You go in there, you can get your lottery numbers put in just there when the shutter's up. And then your Millard's and your big Kasoon. So this is the downstairs part, but just through this alleyway here, we've got the Euro currency, and we're going to check out what the currency is today. But if you need any money changed up, any sterling or whatever nationality currency you need, just through this alleyway here, we've got the currency shop, and they do advertise just outside what the Euro is going to be today. So let's have a look. Still pretty low, I can see 1.15. And it's just in here, just down here, in the corner. Euro exchange. And yeah, you can get a card as well. If you're changing up regular, they give you a card, and after so many visits, you build your points up and you get a better rate every time. That's your Euro exchange. Right next door to the Euro currency, you've got a place here. If you have a problem and you need the vets, the veterinarian here, very good and pretty cheap as well. So if you're not sure about your pets or your animals, you need to get them quick, very reasonable here. You can come down and get checked out. Been there quite a few times with my poor little doggy. Every now and then gets attacked by these ticks
and sometimes the caterpillars, so we've had to rush her a few times.
But yeah, you need a vet. Yeah, I recommend that one, Punta Prima. You've got your washing machine shop there, €5 up to 14 kg for a wash, and €8 if you want to go to the 20 kg wash. Yeah, quite busy. You've got the Samaritan's charity shop just there.
So along here, if you need to get upstairs, you've got your escalators, and also you've got some stairs, and if you're not fit enough to do the stairs, we've got a disability lift just there. And we've got the opticians, we've got the mat free insurance just there, and we've got an hair saloon bang in the middle. And of course you've got your now one beautiful beauty shop, make you look good, all the treatment you want, your eyelashes. They never say these names, but yeah, it's a unisex, they do both by the looks of things, same name, same company. Oh la la, I think that's how you pronounce it anyway. So yeah, we're gonna check upstairs. We're gonna go up on the escalator, and every time we seem to go upstairs, we do get a few new bars and restaurants open, and we're gonna have a look and see what's new and what's not. And I'm gonna take you straight away to Captain's Table. You probably guessed it, middle there, right in the corner. That's where you're gonna get your decent English breakfast, and they have entertainment on, and the fish and chips, supposed to be to die for. They all get takeaways from here, so you might all recommend Casada fish and chips, but I think this could be on equal par. You can get a sandwich for $6.15. Comes with a soup. That is the Captain's Table special board. Two fish and chips, or two steak and chips is. You can have either, your partner can have one or the other, and it comes for €22 a couple, but it does come with a bottle of wine, or you can have a couple of small beers. But it says on that board there, booking is advisable. I know that because it does get busy up here. And just round in this corner here, this is where they seem to have the entertainment on. We've got the Armina Grill Steakhouse just over there. I've actually been in now. Found it pretty expensive, to be truthful. Didn't find anything special, but if you've been in the Armilla Grill House, let us know what your experience was, but we didn't find it that great. And you got the organic shop there for the organic products, but that looks like it could be closed down with an estate agency style. Meanwhile, we're going to walk around. We've got this new Italian pizza place open here, La Plaza. And I do a menu of the day here for €13.99. Comes with a soup, Greek salad, that's your starters, prawn cocktail, calamaris, squids here, that's not for me. And then you've got your main course, chicken breasts, noodles, gammon steak, chips. So yeah, menu of the day. $13.99, hence why it's busy. On the corner here we've got a cocktail bar. Does get very busy in here. Bit rustic as well. They've got the shade down, maybe the sun's too hot for them. But yeah, get yourself a lovely cake as well while you're out. Absolutely look delicious. Rustic cocktail bar. Do get entertainment on here as well on a Saturday from 9 o'clock. Very rustic. Luzia. And that looks out over the car park. Right next door to the Lucia cocktails, in the corner is this Chinese. It used to be a Chinese buffet. It was never great, never busy. It's now our own tea room, our own decor. We're gonna have a look inside and check it out. It's a really nice posh blitz picture frames and furniture in here. You want to live the super rich and have all the bling. There, upmarket tea room. Now that's something different. So if you want to come up, nice get a cake, nice old fashioned tea and coffee. Oh, we've got some lovely cake here as well. Today's special, egg bacon, egg baguette, comes with tea or coffee, $5.50. Get your sausage rolls and your pasties as well. Christmas crackers here. No, they're not 80 euros, just for the table. About 250 for your Christmas crackers. There you go. Now we've got some nice posh furniture here. Cheap as chips, 225. So that's Kutch. The upmarket tea room. I was known as a squeezy oak. Nice cozy season. There we go. Friendly place. We've got a couple of more things left to show you. We've got the tattoo place here if you want your tattoos done, your ear piercing and whatnot. And also you've got your boutique place just next door to it. So that's the Punta Prima. We've shown you some superb, absolutely superb restaurants to go to. And also the best place for fish and chips. And one of the best cozy tea rooms, the Cooch, which has been told, the squeezy hug. Get down to Punta Prima. And if you like the video, make sure you give us a thumbs up. And if you've been to any of these places, let us know in the video what you think, especially the fish and chips. And subscribe, doesn't cost anything. And you'll be notified of my next video, all around the Costa, all around Spain, all around the world.